everyone. Welcome to the BoF wrap-up for July 25th, our second day of BoFs. I'm going to be calling all of the BoF organizers up one by one to tell us what they achieved today, what goalposts they have set, and what goalposts they have passed. I'm going to start with room 2.2, which all day was KDE Neon. It had snapping KDE applications first, and OpenQA. OpenQA sounds like panel. Tell us.
Oh, yes. Yeah, so we spent the entire day talking about Neon. We've started off discussing our experience with the LTS, the Ubuntu LTS as a base, which turned out somewhat favorably. People enjoy the stability that LTS offers. For us as developers, it's been a bit of a challenge, because naturally as our user space software progresses, we need to sort of let the libraries catch up, and doing that in a consistent and non-regressive manner is a bit of a tricky topic. That being said, we decided to move to prepare for the move to 18.04, which is going to be the next Ubuntu LTS release coming out in 2018. We've also talked about snapping, which is containerizing, bundling applications into isolated instances, more or less, which should allow us to update applications in a much more regression-free environment and also in a portable sort of scenario. So we're definitely looking at that, and we actually have active plans to do application releases as snaps moving forward. So I don't know what the next application release is, something 17.12, yes, 17.12 should probably be entirely snap-based unless we encounter big showstoppers there. Then we talked a bit about OpenQA, looked at our current tech for OpenQA. It's working well for our primary use case, which is ISO validation. For the application testing, there's still lots of stuff to be done, and that's something to do. We've also looked at ARM builds, incorporating the builds of Plasma Mobile into the Neon scope, as there is a vast overlap between the two projects, and so in order to conserve build resources and also management, there's a bit of activity going on in folding the two into one big project that builds 64-bit Intel architecture and ARM architecture at the same time. We've also looked a bit at how our infrastructure behaves and how Plasma releases work in the context of our infrastructure as well as on their own. There are some refinements to be made, but nothing particularly interesting there. We've also looked at a bit of the user experience side. Currently we are having trouble with actually allowing people to install additional languages after the initial installation of the system. There's a bunch of stuff that needs engineering there. Also a big topic is driver installation, driver management, so users can install proprietary drivers rather than free drivers if they do so choose. Again, lots of engineering needed there. We've also talked about Calamares, our hopefully future installer, going to replace the Ubuntu-based installer called Ubiquity. We haven't gone into great detail. There's a bunch of improvements that need to be made architecturally in order to facilitate the stuff that we want to do, which is a more concurrent sort of workflow, which should offer quicker installation and also a configuration during the installation itself, which would be really awesome. To end the day, we've then done a GPG key signing BoF, where we went around in circles and looked at each other's IDs and hopefully soon sign each other's keys, so that should be awesome too. So that's it from me. Yes, thank you.
That's what you get for running an all-day BoF. Room 2.3 was much more varied, much more interesting, I'm sure. Because it had Bashan and Valerie, who were full of fun, and Summer of Code.
Okay, so we had a KDE SoC BoF. We host this every year to discuss about our adding programs which are built according to Google Summer of Code and Season of KDE, and we discussed about how this year's program went for us, how the changes in Google Summer of Code program schedule have helped us or not. We asked the participants and mentors for the suggestion on how to improve our mentoring programs and how to improve our workflow. And there were some nice suggestions, and there were some also task points with which we have to work upon. So yeah, that's pretty much it.
Dave is going to tell us about Wayland.
There was a Wayland BoF where we invited people to make apps or want to run Plasma or Wayland to test their apps, see what works, see what might not work. Mostly things seemed good. We found a bunch of issues to fix around the stack. We fixed a few people's personal setups. BoF fixed a very important icon in Gamma Ray. And we worked on practically fixing a lot of things, including some quite difficult problems.
Thank you, Dave. The K develop team was active.
K develop, we basically were discussing about some issues we knew we had already, but it's kind of issues that you don't want to talk about generally, but well, since we were face to face, it was a good moment to do so. It was mostly improving different languages. Also, we were talking about merging a bunch of repositories that we have split at the moment, which hopefully can help get new developers at some point. That was the biggest thing, besides very nitpicky issues on the technical part.
Okay, the user feedback is undoubtedly vulgar.
So we discussed using the user feedback in Plasma in particular, and can be blind in general, and the implication that would have on global configuration. There are some challenges in doing all of process configuration for Plasma in system settings that we need to address. And another global setting we will be introducing is like a user or system-wide kit switch that disables not only the entire data submission but also all the encouragements with the UI to enable it, because there are some concerns from organizations that want to disable that for an entire format. Easy enough to end, we'll do that. Regarding infrastructure, we'll work with sysadmins to get this deployed on KDE servers, so we can actually use it in production for our applications. And finally, starting with a discussion on can individual applications have opt-out rather than opt-in. We'll write KDE-wide policy on what we want to track or what we allow to track, how we review that, so kind of the code of telemetric conduct. Well, it makes sense to have
dedicated review
and ensure that this is all up to our privacy standards. Yep, that's basically.
Hey, Mycroft.
You're supposed to be.
Tell us about your BoF.
Was MicroBoF, and we spoke about basically discuss what's the future for the MicroBoF Plasma on Plasma Desktop. We also discussed some of the complexities of the packaging issue that MicroBoF is facing, and we discussed on some cool skills that we could add to MicroBoF, like screenshots and make a generic media player skill. Also in the discussion was a bit about the privacy issue. Creating a message that warns the users that it uses Google SG team. So yeah, that's about it. Thank you.
Together at the end of the day.
So we talked today about some of the short-term, medium-term, and long-term vision that we want to accomplish for Plasma. And obviously, Plasma is a graphical design, has a graphical environment, so we have to think about this quite often. And so we developed some goals and some things that we have to do going forward and that our team is going to help with. So expect a lot of change and a lot of, you know, feeling too comfortable is not going to happen. So we're going to ask you to, you know, put up with us a lot, and so we hope for your cooperation. Other than that, thank you.
Moving on to room 2.4, we have a BoF on the KDE Slim Book and what we've learned from that lovely little machine.
It was a more of a discussing kind of forum than actually like getting things done place. We mostly discussed about how we need to learn about the experience, we need to know more about the people who actually bought the device. We need to know more about the kind of companies that would be interested in doing an experience such as that. Like, we need to continue talking to Slimbook, but maybe there's other manufacturers that would be interested in repeating. Like, the whole point of us thinking about it is whether we should continue doing this or not. Right? We've been discussing about whether we should actually get like group of hardware manufacturers or assemblers together, or much like our advisory board, we should discuss it again. But I think that the conclusion is more or less that it would be a good idea to do it again at some point, maybe not yet. But then there's also some places where we could be improving, like making sure that the hardware is exactly what we want, and to make sure that processes that the company has in place are up to our expectations. But then, we can do that, especially because, like you said, we don't want to do it like now really again, but maybe in a year, or maybe some months, or 5 years, whatever. But then there's room for improvement, and we will do that, and we see where it goes, if at all.
Later on in that room, we had some conqueror thinking.
Conqueror is dead. Long live Conqueror. You might want a bit more details than that. Basically, I've been reviving a little bit the effort on Conqueror lately, making it work with WebMachine. And the idea initially for this buff was to figure out what people want out of Conqueror. And then I learned that there is an existing Qt WebMachine-based browser called Capzilla, which is actually quite polished, has a lot of stuff. And my temptation now is to simply drop Conqueror completely and use Capzilla. And actually, we talked to the Capzilla maintainer on the on IRC. And so right now it's a GitHub project, and he's open to the idea of moving that to the community. And we also jokingly suggested to change the name, because the name actually sucks, to Conqueror, right? So Conqueror is the Conqueror. And he was actually okay with the idea if we were okay with it.
We talked about our effort to get contact for Windows built. Hopefully that will get
yet soon. Folger made KDPIM work on Wayland, so we just need to fix a few lines and we can work on Wayland now. We also focused on our developer story, so we want to make it as easy as possible for new developers to start working on KDPIM. It's not easy given the amount of repositories and the dependencies between them, so we want to make their lives easier and hopefully attract new contributors thanks to that. We'll be also merging or streaming the Exchange support, which currently is done by some guy on GitHub, so we will be merging them to KDPIM runtime, so that all our users will have a chance to use Microsoft Exchange. We also finalized the KML user survey and will be publishing it very, very soon. And we talked about our plans for the Randa Sprint in September.
Thank you, Dan. The last BoF, but not the last thing we'll be talking about, is the big music player BoF. It's early in the morning. And Tomas can tell us something about music.
Yeah, so the main topics that we, well, the main topic that we had was what would need to be done in order for BAME to be portable to Kirigami, so that we can then also have it on mobile. The name discussion also came up, and we came to the conclusion that we maybe should brainstorm on a new name, which the visual design group is going to do. And then we discussed a bit about things like should the player integrate services like Spotify or Last.fm, and also currently it does play from YouTube, and you can rip from YouTube, and then we discussed the possible legal implications and how we could still use YouTube but in a way that would not be a legal gray area, because we want the player to be packaged by all distributions, even those which probably would work with that. And we also talked a bit about how it could be integrated with Mycroft, and about how Dbus could be used to, for example, offer a KRunner plugin so that you could from KRunner directly start playing music. That's one. Yeah, and also input support, how to improve them.
Okay, last two things. I'd like to ask my lovely and talented assistant, Albert, and my other lovely and talented assistant, Scarlett, to come forward.
Because
those of you who have filled in the Akademy user satisfaction survey and have left a name have all been entered in a draw to win a Slimbo. And here's a completely random QML application, I'm sure, and the button will be pressed to reveal the winner. And the winner is Franklin Wang. And since Franklin went home yesterday, the Slimbo will be posted. Very, very last thing, everyone who wants to rock the Casbah, catch the bus and be quick about it. This is later this evening. Thank you for coming, and see you all.